statement about the hearing today sa committee ni Senator Bato. Now, we were monitoring the committee hearings being conducted by the Committee on Public Order, and very serious accusations have been made. Whether they have merit or not, it's a whole other matter. While certain claims were made, documentary evidence is yet to be presented. There were no pictures, no corroborating testimonies. In other words, this was solely based on a testimony of one person based on what appears to be hearsay evidence. Morales cites a document which he claims to have seen by the virtue of his former position, although he did not personally witness any wrongdoing. And the drug test of the president, even the drug test of the president is being brought up, even though it does not appear to be germane or important to the subject matter of the motu proprio investigation. Under a court of law, guilt must be proven beyond reasonable doubt. While legislative inquiries are very liberal in terms of adhering to rules of evidence, it is our opinion that hearings should aim to ferret out the truth using evidence and facts. Otherwise, the faith of the people in legislative inquiries in aid of legislation may be diminished, especially when it comes to reputational damage to other parties. There have been instances where statements were made in legislative inquiries only to be recanted before the courts later on. We do not want a repeat of that. We respect the committee's right to perform oversight functions in aid of legislation. However, we just like to remind our colleagues to be very careful not to use the hearings in aid of political persecution. Yun lamang po. Maraming salamat. And my final says, no matter our political affiliations, senators must be in one in preserving the integrity of the constitutional duty to conduct inquiries in aid of legislation. So, yun lamang po. Thank you. I trust Senator Bato, nag-usap kami kahapon, kinumit niya sa akin na hindi ito magiging political witch hunt. Yun nga lang, pero kanina nung pinanood ko yung hearing, mukhang yung mga witness nila ay going beyond what should be given under testimony under a court of law. For example, evidence must have been presented, hindi pwedeng hearsay evidence, yan ang binanggit ni Senator Jinggoy. Mahirap yung hearsay evidence eh. If we accept hearsay evidence, marami po tayong matatanggap dito na witnesses na gano'n na lang, gagawa na lang sila ng storya na narinig nila galing kay Juan de la Cruz na ito ay gumagawa ng ganito, ito ay nagpatay ng tao, ito ay nagnakaw. Kailangan meron tayong direct evidence, facts that we can present. It has to be a preponderance of evidence to be able to come up with the right answers and conclusion to this case. Kaya, ang akin lang dyan, mag-ingat lang tayo, huwag po tayo magpagamit for political persecution. This goes for every committee hearing, ha? Hindi lamang ito. Alam ko, magkakaroon committee hearing dito sa gentleman's agreement. Ganun din. Ang caution ko sa chairperson and the members of the Senate is let us try to avoid making these hearings into a political circus or for a political witch hunt. Thank you. Well, ayoko i-preempt ang decision ng ating chairman about that. Ang akin lang, ang position ko lang, habang nagmo-monitor ako kanina, wala naman sila napapakitang panibagong ebidensya, kundi yung sinasabi lang nilang dokumento. Hindi nga galing sa kanya yung dokumento, galing pa sa isang informant na ayaw niya pangalanan, eh pala, wala tayong, paano yun, hindi first-hand information. Buti sana kung siya mismo ang nakakita ng krimen o yung masamang pangyayari. Hindi. Galing lang siya sa informant niya. So let's be very careful about that, gentlemen, ladies. Thank you very much, ha. Thank you. Well, you know, we could lose credibility as an institution. Maraming magagalit sa amin, unduly, of course, undue anger and resentment to the Senate by different political clans and parties na ayaw naman na natin mangyari. Unang-una, makakatulong ba ito para pag-resolba ng problema ng inflation sa ating bansa na mahal na bilihin? Sa tingin ko, hindi. Makakatulong ba ito para maingat na angat natin ang kahirapan, mawala ang kahirapan at maangat natin ang ating mga kababayan sa kahirapan? Sa tingin ko, hindi. Ito po ay makakababa pa ng presyo ng kuryente sa ating bansa? Sa tingin ko po ay hindi. Pero binibigyan po natin karapatan ang ating mga chairpersons at committees to do their function, oversight functions para sa mga panukala in aid of legislation. Yun nga lang, we have a responsibility to the public. We have a responsibility to the public. Maraming salamat. Thank you very much. Yes.